power on. Dial a phone number in by punching the keys in and hit send. Tell me how long that process takes you from a phone with power off. And now imagine doing this under stress. I know on my iPhone takes approximately 30 seconds to power on from when I push the power button. 30 seconds before I can even get to the screen where I can touch the keypad on the touchscreen. 30 seconds just to that point. Now imagine doing this under stress if your cell phone power was off. You know, you just got to get realistic about this stuff. And if you were counting down seconds and something's going wrong, somebody encircles your minivan with a couple of guys, and you look at 30 seconds on a stopwatch, that's a long time when you got something bad going on. Your cell phone is not the magic ticket. It is a good tool. Don't get me wrong. I go everywhere. Everywhere I go, my cell phone's on me. And if there was a situation where something happened and I would call the police right away. But your cell phone is not the magic ticket. Too many people rely on that too much. But if something was to happen to you, of course you're going to try to call the police, and you should. But when seconds count, you'll see how long it takes you to get a number through. Then let alone how long it's going to take the police to get where you're at. It could be 3 minutes. It could be 25 minutes. And when something's going wrong right at that time, that's a long time to wait. So you're just going to have to decide what you want to do as far as being out there. I think that universities should let carry concealed permit holders carry a gun. Why strip the good guys the right to defend themselves? And if one guy snaps and comes in there with a gun, well, you've guaranteed that all the good guys will die. That's all you did. We need to stop letting the good guys be victims. It's plain and simple. Just like the 9/11 thing. I don't want to get into the plane thing because I don't know about people shooting and hitting a window or whatever, but if people were allowed to carry on an airplane, how could things have been different the day of the 9/11 stuff? If somebody had a concealed gun and they didn't know who it was on there, and this guy pulls out a box cutter and he cuts somebody, and all of a sudden about two seats back, a guy stands up, pulls out a 1911, and takes this guy out. We could have maybe saved one plane load of people. But like I said, I don't want to get into the whole airplane thing and guns because I don't know all the specifics on, like, if a window was shot out in the pressurized cabin and all that. I don't know anything about all of those details. But it's just an example. I feel that teachers in high schools and colleges and universities, if they have a permit, should be allowed, definitely 100%, to carry a gun. In fact, I think it should be a good thing, and looked upon as a good thing, and encouraged for, like, a high school teacher to carry a concealed handgun if that person is so inclined to do so. I would feel much safer in that environment. So we just need to quit listening to what the media says and think about how we could change things. That's a step in the right direction. Maybe there's a high school math teacher I think Hickok 45 is a teacher, and I'm not giving, this is no personal information, and I think he said this on his channel. I can't say for sure. But I think he said he was a teacher. Now, can you imagine somebody like Hickok 45 being able to conceal carry a gun in a school? Man, I would feel so safe. That guy can shoot. But can you imagine why they would restrict somebody like Hickok 45 from carrying a gun inside of a place like that? He has the ability to save everybody. And if something would go wrong, he could save hundreds of lives and injuries. And, you know, sometime I hope that the liberals can get some common sense and start to see what we really need to do. You see, banning guns is not the issue. Like I've said before, let's ban killing. Let's see how far that gets us. Okay? So it's silly for me to say, let's ban killing, right? Because killing's illegal. So for you, being a liberal, to tell me, let's ban guns, that is just as silly to me. Because when you ban guns, only guys that follow the law will no longer have a gun. That's the only guys that won't have the gun. It'll be open and free reign to the guys that wanna do harm, and they would still get a gun. There's always a way. There's a black market, you know. You guys know it'd be like with the drug thing in the United States. It, you know, whatever you want is out there. If you know the right people, you can get it. Everything. So banning guns makes no sense to me. You might as well just start by banning murder and see how far that goes. Restricting the law-abiding citizens has never helped in any way, shape, or form with the crime rate in any state in this country. And I don't know what it is with the liberals. I'm not big into politics. I don't follow politics at all. But I do know how certain people, Hillary Clinton, Bill Clinton, there's so many more, our current president, he hasn't done a lot yet, but he does not like firearms. I don't care what you show me or what he said, he does not like firearms. These guys will say about anything they can to get in office. Who else? Dianne Feinstein. And you know, just places like California. California is like a separate country to me from the rest of the US. And I'm not making fun of any of you guys that are into guns that's into California. I understand that it's not the way you want it to be. But when I speak of saying that California to me seems like a different country, I'm speaking about the lawmakers and the way they make laws and what laws you guys have there. I started looking into the laws in California and the gun laws and things, and it's so different from where I'm at and most places in the U.S. It's just, it's hard to believe that state is in the same country that I'm in. And I don't understand how it slid that far back, you know, and reversed. And L.A. and all the crime out there, how much of that crime has stopped out in places like Los Angeles, California, Long Beach, and all that stuff? I mean, is California crime free? You guys have the strictest gun laws in the United States. So I imagine if I go to California right now, there is no crime. It's all, everything's all puffy white clouds, right? Little bunnies running around. It's not the way it is. What you'll find is the states with the most restrictive gun carry have the highest crime rates. D.C., California, New York. There's three examples. Strictest gun laws, highest and worst crime rates. It's the way it always is. And to think that there's people in this country that just can't get that through their noggin. You know, what do we got to do? You know, they can pull up stats and statistics all day. I don't buy into all that stuff. I don't buy into their statistics and things like that. But it's just common sense. Every man has a right to defend himself. It's a God-given right. You have a right to not... You have a right not to fear for your life. You have a right to have something on you that can save your life. That's just the way it is, and that's just the way it should be. So I think I'll go ahead and end the video there, and I hope this helped. If maybe you're thinking about getting your permit, or maybe if you're like 19 or 20 and you're not of age yet to get it, just some things to think about. And just go over in your head before you do anything. I encourage you to get your carry concealed permit. And if you're nervous at first when you get your carry concealed permit, that's fine. That's a normal feeling. You go out in the public and you feel like everybody's looking at you. It's a normal feeling and it will go away. You'll get used to it, to having your gun. But having your gun is always a sobering feeling, and you always know it's there, and that's a healthy thing. That's the way it should be. But that's just some of my feelings on the issue. All right, everyone. Humans for Targets. And I'm out.